Alright everyone, quick video review of Spider-Man No Way Home. This is going to be spoiler free. That's going to make this a very difficult review because there's so much to talk about and I can't. I'll keep it very simple. I went into this movie with high expectations. Phase 4 has been good so far, but it missed the magic of the actual real MCU. Black Widow was a wonderful movie. COVID ended up affecting that performance. Shang-Chi was surprisingly good. I really like Shang-Chi. And the Eternals, while I really enjoyed the Eternals, seemed like it was moving in a slightly different direction than your typical MCU feeling of a movie. But it certainly is a huge movie in regards to storytelling. Spider-Man No Way Home brings things back together. And you realize this is still the MCU. These are the people we love. It's got Spider-Man, right? Doctor Strange, right? Fantastic. The special effects in the movie were, of course, top-notch. I really think there was only one scene where I thought it looked a little cheesy. But other than that, and it was just one quick blip. But other than that, looked fantastic. Some of the effects were so mind-bogglingly good that you actually realized, wow, this is amazing, the things that they can do and the way they can make it look so real. I really appreciated No Way Home because they put a primary focus, it seemed to me, on storytelling to make a cohesive, reasonable, lucid story that had so many different variables. You think, man, in anyone else's hands, they would have really messed this up, but they didn't. The movie is not overwrought with excessive action scenes. The action scenes are necessary. They feel organic and natural, part of the movie. They're not drawn out for the sake of runtime. Story is of primary importance, and that's something that I really, really like. So you're going to get plenty of action, but instead of feeling like, oh great, another fight scene, you're like, okay, this fight scene is necessary. Just a wonderful movie. All of the actors did a great job. I was really amazed with the casting, and that is going to blow your mind. When I think about the writers, what they must have gone through, and the casting directors, what they had to go through to pull this movie off, I'm utterly amazed. Absolutely sensational. Definitely check this movie out. It feels like the early days of the Marvel Cinematic Universe, but it's gotten bigger. And that's what was scary to a lot of people. Will it become so big that it loses the magic that we feel? No, it didn't. It did a great job. If you go see it in the theater, absolutely make sure you watch the mid-credit scene and the post-credit scene. The Marvel Universe just keeps getting bigger and bigger, and man, seems like it has a tremendously bright future, of course. So, I guess the difficult question is, which did I like more? Homecoming, No Way Home, Far From Home, or No Way Home? I loved all three of them. I would dare say almost equally. This new one definitely has some pulling on your heartstrings. There's sadness in the movie. There's joy. There's everything you need. There's tons of comedy, great action, fantastic storytelling, bit of self-awareness, and it doesn't take itself too seriously, nor does it take itself too lightly. So I would have a tough time. There are elements of each movie that are just sheer brilliant. They're just sheer brilliance, I should say. But thankfully, I don't have to choose. I definitely say check it out on a big screen if you can, so we can get the full impact. It's absolutely worth a ticket to the movie theater. Would it be worth seeing on IMAX? Absolutely. That's the way I usually rate movies on. Is it worthy of IMAX, or is it just worthy of being on the big screen? Is it just wait till it gets to rental? and view it at home or wait for it to get to broadcast TV. And I say this is absolutely worth whatever cost to go see. See it at IMAX if you want. Don't miss it. Far From Home is fantastic. And here's one spoiler I will give you that isn't a spoiler about the movie. It's about Tom Holland's future with the MCU. People have questioned. But from what I read a couple weeks ago, Tom Holland has signed on to do 3 more movies. So if that's any indication of the hope that they have for the character and the fans to support, I don't know what else is. So like I said, the future for the MCU looks very bright indeed. And definitely can't wait to see what's next. Thanks for watching. I hope you check it out. If you do see it, let me know in the comment section what you think. If you have seen it, let me know what you liked. But please, let's be mindful of not providing any type of spoiler for anyone that hasn't seen the movie yet. Please give them a few weeks to get to the theaters to see it. God bless. Thanks.